Penguin Random House Audio presents Power Score, Your Formula for Leadership Success by ghSMART, Randy Street and Alan Foster. Read by the authors Randy Street and Alan Foster. Chapter 1. Full Power. The most useful book about leadership.
That is what we hope you and your team will say after finishing Power Score.
Other books promise this.
That's true, but three things make this one unique. First, it's based on the largest body of research of its kind. Over the past 20 years, we have conducted in-depth interviews, 4 hours in length, of more than 15,000 leaders, producing more than 9 million data points.
That's a lot of data.
It is. If you think listening to the advice of one leader is helpful, imagine having 15,000 leaders giving you their best advice. The Wall Street Journal has called our database coveted. Research teams from top universities have helped us analyze the data. And the leadership advisors at ghSMART have reflected upon our clients' biggest challenges and how they have led to success or failure. We have distilled this research and advice into a simple score that you can calculate with your team. It highlights exactly what you need to do to achieve your goals. We truly believe you will come to see this as the secret formula for success.
What's the second reason this book is useful and different?
We designed this book in Q&A format to make it easy and fun to read. You ask the questions.
I ask the questions?
That's right. You ask the questions and I respond. This book is a conversation. We'll tell you what we know and what you need to know. And we'll share some amazing stories, people who turned their companies, their teams, and even their lives around by using the Power Score.
That's a big claim.
It is, but we know that we can back it up. These ideas have been battle-tested for nearly 2 decades in thousands of big companies, entrepreneurial ventures, and even social service agencies. They work. We have even put them into practice ourselves. We'll tell you about times when we have failed and learned so you can avoid our mistakes with your own team.
So what is this book about?
That brings us to the third reason this book is so useful. We provide a simple formula called the Power Score that enables you and your team to identify ways to improve your results. When your team achieves better results, you will have a more positive impact on the world. You will make a bigger difference for your cause, whatever that might be. And you will enjoy more career success.
My team and I want those things. So what is this Power Score?
It's our grand unified theory of leadership, boiled down to one number, your Power Score. When you make changes that drive your Power Score up, your results will improve. If you let your Power Score go down, your results will suffer.
How do we calculate our Power Score?
Pull your team together for a power conversation. We provide a how-to template at the end of the book to use as a reference. Begin the conversation by asking them, "Are we running at full power?" Listen to what they say. Their observations will be vague at first, but pay close attention to their comments because they will be your first indication of what you can do differently. Then ask them to think about three things, P, W, and R. P stands for priorities. Do we have the right priorities? W stands for who. Do we have the right who? R stands for relationships. Do we have the right relationships? Ask each team member to rate all three variables on a 1 to 10 scale, with 10 being the top score. Then have them multiply the three numbers together, calculators are allowed, and hold up their answers. P times W times R equals power score.
PWR spells power. I get it.
Bingo. We made the formula PWR spell power to make it easy to remember.
Holding up the scores sounds like a nerve-wracking moment. What is a good score?
A perfect score, of course, is 1,000. 10 times 10 times 10 equals 1,000. But that is nearly impossible. More realistically, a score of 729 or higher means your team is operating at full power.
Why only 729?
Because perfection is not a useful goal. You should never feel bad for not achieving perfection, because nobody can do it. We doubt that even Warren Buffett scores a perfect 1,000. But if your P is a 9, your W is a 9, and your R is a 9, you are doing extremely well. 9 times 9 times 9 equals 729. If your team achieves a power score of 729 or higher, we say you are running your team at full power. Congratulations! Great job! Pat yourselves on the back and keep doing what you're doing. Only about 1 in 10 teams runs at full power at any given time. If your power score is between 500 and 700, you are still doing pretty well. 8 times 8 times 8 equals 512. You are not too far off the mark, and chances are you will find that just a few tweaks will get you to full power. About 30% of teams run at this level. Everybody else falls below 500 and runs well short of full power. If that happens to you, then you have to figure out what, or who, is dragging your score down and take action to get back to 729 or above.
So what do I do with my power score once I calculate it?
Once all the people on your team have shared their overall numbers, discuss why they rated each element, P, W, and R, the way they did. This is a critical part of the power conversation. Listen to their ideas to improve the score on each dimension. When you do those things, your power score will improve, and so will your results.
Who are you three authors, and why should I trust you?
Hi, nice to meet you. We are Geoff, Randy, and Alan. We are business leaders, best-selling authors, and social entrepreneurs. We are not academics, we are not retired CEOs, and this is not a memoir. We are not self-proclaimed gurus or TV evangelists. We are three guys who love the topic of helping leaders amplify their positive impact on the world. This is why we write books. We are humbled that so many people have read our previous two books, Who and Leadocracy, making them bestsellers and helping them win awards. We work at ghSMART, a leadership consultancy. We have the privilege to serve as the trusted advisors to leaders who own or run large institutions. For two decades, these leaders have called ghSMART to help them hire and develop talented teams that achieve results. But don't just take our word for it. Here are some other people who have said our approach to leadership has merit. Harvard Business School wrote two business school cases titled ghSMART and Company, Pioneering in Professional Services. Atul Gawande praised our disciplined approach to leadership in The Checklist Manifesto. Tom Peters in The Little Big Things called our approach to hiring leaders a big damn deal. George Anders in The Rare Find concluded that of all approaches to evaluating and selecting leaders, the principles practiced by ghSMART appear to be the most effective. Maureen Broderick gave us props for being a top firm in The Art of Managing Professional Services, Insights from Leaders of the World's Top Firms.
Okay. So you seem to know what you're talking about, but does the power score actually work? How much more successful are the leaders who run their teams at full power?
Twice as successful. Leaders who run their teams at full power are twice as likely to have succeeded in their careers as the average leader, and they are a whopping 20 times more likely to have succeeded than people whose power scores are in the bottom 10%.
Are you making that up?
Nope. Every number in this book comes from that database and research we mentioned.
Tell me more about your research.
Each of our 15,000 assessments was a semi-structured interview that lasted between 4 and 5 hours. It covered a leader's entire educational and career history, including jobs held, key accomplishments, failures, strengths, weaknesses, relationships that worked and didn't work, leadership styles, thought patterns, personality traits, and motivations. All told, we collected more than 600 data points per person, more than 9 million data points in all. Just over a third of those we assessed were CEOs, and the vast majority of the remaining ones were their direct reports or other senior executives. We have also interviewed nonprofit leaders, military generals, school principals, and head surgeons to give you a sense of the variety of people we have met. Power is a universal framework for leadership. After each assessment, we analyze the data to identify patterns of success and failure. In one assessment, for example, we saw that the candidate had trouble with his father as a child. and problems with authority figures throughout the rest of his career. In another, a hard-charging candidate dropped out of school to work in the oil patch and ended up building a massively successful oil services company through a combination of scrappiness, hard work, and exceptional ingenuity. For every assessment we do.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.